In India, millions of people are learning English because they want better jobs, more opportunities, and growth in life. That is what happens with most of the English learners due to wrong methods. If you are really serious and if you want to understand the psychology behind English communication, then this video is for you. Many of you are eager to develop your English communication skills. I know that. But do you know the fact? Most of you will give up. Most of you will not improve. This is a fact. How many actually improve? There are, in India, millions of people are learning English because they want better jobs, more opportunities, and growth in life. Fact of the matter is, how many actually improve? 2%. 98% don't improve. What is the reason behind this? And the reason is found by Dr. Martin Seligman in his book, Learned Helplessness. Dear friends, I apply psychology to communication skills, and that is what I'm going to do here today. If you are really serious and if you want to understand the psychology behind English communication, then this video is for you. Now, understand how it works actually. There is a concept which is called as learned helplessness, and this is the main reason why most of us, 98%, leave English, don't improve it, give up, and continue with their daily routine with their broken English. Nothing changes in them. See how it works. There was an experiment that he performed in Stanford University. The experiment was very simple. There was a compartment. In one compartment, one like box kind of thing, there was one dog kept in one side of the box, but there was a partition here and there was empty space here. This dog, which was kept, he was given electrical shocks, not too severe, but mild shocks. And then this dog, of course, tried to jump that partition, wanted to go in another compartment, couldn't go. Shocks were given day in and day out. I mean, always like 1 day, 2 day, 3 day. And a stage came when the dog even stopped reacting to the shocks, just sitting quietly, I mean, just taking the shocks. I hope you can imagine. Then what he did is he took off the partition, that space that separated the escape space he could have escaped, and that space where he was sitting, and then he gave the shock. Friends, out of 10 dogs, 7 dogs did not jump. They were just sitting there. And 3 dogs jumped there. Those 7 dogs who were sitting there, what happened? Even though there was no partition, they could have jumped. They did not. Why? This is called as learned helplessness. This dog, that dog who was sitting here, he realized that, or he believed that, what is the point in jumping there? I can't do anything. I'm helpless. I tried earlier, but it's not working. So it's better to give up. That is what happens with most of the English learners. Due to wrong methods, they try and speak and try to improve, and lot of things they do. But what happens, a stage comes when they see there is no improvement in them and they become helpless and they give up. They give up. Let us talk about these 3 people, 3 dogs who jumped. They suffered initially, but they jumped. These people, why they jump? Because of attribution therapy, or attribution theory it is called. What is attribution? Because these 3 dogs who jumped, they did not become helpless. The reason is the way they explained themselves, that particular incident, they explained themselves. What happens? Like, these 3 dogs said that, okay, I'm here. I'm getting shocks, but things can change. Things can change. It is not permanent. It is not pervasive. It is not personal. Permanent, pervasive, personal means what? Permanent means, no, this is not permanent. This will change. Pervasive means what? This does not mean that I'm hopeless everywhere. I'm only helpless in this area. I can't jump there. Okay? Permanent, pervasive, and personal. Personal means, no, I'm not bad. I'm not useless. Only I have to work on this particular skill. I can improve it. I'm not making complicated. Hope so. That's the reason why these 3 dogs jumped. Those 7 thought, oh, I can't do anything. I'm helpless. I can't improve. I'm not intelligent. I can't change the things. This is the main reason why 98% people use the wrong methods, get stuck in that dog's place. They get the shocks. I mean, shocks means what? Their English is poor. People, their boss is telling, improve your communication skills. They realize talking to the clients and all, but they're trying with the wrong methods. Studying grammar is the wrong method. And they become helpless. And a stage comes when they just give up. That's the way it works. Okay, friends, so in which category are you? 7 or 3? Are you in that 98% or are you in that 2%? And that is what I do in my institute. I train my students psychologically, I change their mindset, and I bring them into the 2% category. And one more thing I want to say here. You can do it. It's possible. It's possible. We can change it. Thanks a lot, dear friends, for watching this video. And namaste. Namaste. Goodbye. Thanks a lot.